Welcome to another episode of Sip and Sync with Azure. Today, we're going to be talking about automation and security for AI deployments. And I'm actually going to dial in my friend, David, from Australia. So let me pull him in. Hey, David, how are you?
Hey, how are you going? Good. Or should I say good day?
Well, it's fine. Where are you calling us from?
I'm in Sydney, I work with Microsoft globally across all regions.
Awesome. So for our audience here, I think some of the developer folks know about HashiCorp, but do you mind giving a quick elevator pitch for HashiCorp? And I know you all went through some acquisition recently.
Yeah, so HashiCorp, now an IBM company. We are predominantly known for our infrastructure as code tool Terraform, but we also have a suite of products that are associated with infrastructure and security lifecycle management in the DevOps space. So we have Packer for image creation. We have Vault for security, which cut some of the really relevant products around this topic. We also have Vault Radar that we just actually launched recently in GA, which is about finding secrets and making sure secrets don't slip into that DevOps workflow.
Awesome. Now, we keep hearing that most AI projects, stall before production. Why is the last mile so hard, and how is HashiCorp going to solve that?
So when we've been talking to our customers, we've seen kind of three top priorities keep cropping up. The first of those is struggle with actually getting going. So how do I get my project going? Then there's a new security challenge that we have kind of seen that is creeping in around the confused deputy construct. And then once you get past those challenges, it's then getting into how do I scale that across my organization? And so HashiCorp has got kind of our suite of products to actually solve those problems and challenges. So in the building foundations component, we have worked with Microsoft and built the Azure Verified modules, for example, which allow us to use pre-built, well-architected and best practices in repeatable constructs to allow organizations to then just consume those modules and get started really quickly. In the new security challenge, Vault offers the ability to do some dynamic things with solving that confused deputy, and we can talk about that a little bit more. And then in enterprise scale, you can use those HashiCorp cloud platform to actually scale using something like the private module registry, those predetermined best practice modules across your enterprise, by giving it to using highly skilled teams to build them and then giving it to lesser teams who may not understand the ins and outs of the actual build, but can run it and stand it up quickly and easily, and therefore give you scale to that overall project.
Awesome. I am definitely interested in this new security challenge because that is top of mind for a lot of AI deployments and quite frankly, the risk that this could introduce. So if you could please elaborate on that, that would be great.
Sure. So, as we said, we know that a lot of organizations are failing to move through that into production. And that's because these environments are really, really complex. So when we think about this complex environment, how do you build this? How do you secure it? How do you stand this up? And that's some of the traditional components. With the construct of the new security challenge, we also see that with the rise of AI agents and with RAG environments, so retrieval augmented generative environments, this introduces a new security challenge based on the confused deputy construct. And for those that don't understand, the confused deputy is where unintentional misuse of the system allows for it to go beyond its privileges by manipulation from a user input. And so as these systems gain access to sensitive data, as we sort of integrate the agents with APIs and allow them to do more execution capabilities, this grows the risk of malicious or manipulative prompts being used to get that AI system to act beyond its actually intended permission. And this is critical in thinking about how we can provide context-aware control, fine-grained identity boundaries, and rigorous trust models to ensure that the AI doesn't actually get confused and acts beyond that. And this is where HashiCorp's Vault can actually add a lot of value around that by allowing it to enact and actually create dynamic credentials based on those short-lived constructs and allow for AI agents to access data and security on a per session and full traceability so that each action and session can actually be traced and allow for easy connection between who's doing or who's asking and who's actually getting that information, and tying those two things together in an easy construct. And this is a really important part of solving that confused deputy problem.
This is amazing. Yeah, you're right. You know, I'm also seeing these agents kind of do on behalf of user flows or sometimes have their own identities of late. So can we make this more concrete? Like, do you have an application you could show?
Sure. Sure, yeah. So this is just a really basic application that I built. Stands up, all built within Terraform. The application, all of this is built up using infrastructure as code. So we can really use that infrastructure as code approach. But in it, we have the ability to, we have three agents effectively. There is a calculator, a web search, and a SQL database search. In that, we can ask for something simple like, in the DB, find the population of a country and compare to the web and calculate the difference. Now, what this is doing is it's actually going out and asking for multiple stages across those agents. So those three agents are going out and actually performing that task. So you can see here, it's gone out, it's understood what the number in our database was, it's found the number on the web, and it's actually compared the differences between that. So these are the actual actions that it's taken underneath that. In our construct, in our actual code, when we look at that, what we do is if we go and look at our logs, we can see that each of those individual actions has then been actually authorized. So we've got the initialization. We have a token that has been asked for and provided using OICD. That token is then specifically given permission and rights to access the information. It's authorized against our Azure authorization engine. So it uses part of the federation credentials to assume that you have access and the right permissions based on your Kubernetes environment. And then it actually identifies with a unique session identity that is tied to that permission. So as you go through and start to take on other accesses, so for I need to have dynamic access to my database for that first request, so it actually ties that meta entity to it. And now we can actually have a way of tracking who asked, what session, where they went, and what they did. And so all these things become tied together to allow for information to be easily traceable, but also be able to be dynamic and have no long-lived credentials based anywhere.
This is amazing. You know, this type of governance and auditability is something that a lot of my customers ask as well. So, you know, this is really great, and thanks for making it concrete. Now, where can our audience kind of find, whether it's this code or more information about this product?
So we can go through into, I actually have this code in my repo that people can go and test and play with. It's not production ready, I should say that. But if you go into our call to actions, there are lots of things that we can do. So go onto our website. There is actually an AI specific construct within Terraform. If you look at or reach out to any of your, even your account executives, we can engage and help you establish and solve these challenges.
Thank you, David. So there's a lot of resources that was kind of shared to help you get started. We're going to have all of that in the description. See you again on another episode of Sip and Sync.